Hi friends, this is Indla Srinivas Rao, Assistant Professor, Department of Medical Surgical Nursing, Gangashil School of Nursing, Bareilly. I welcome you all to my channel. You know that nowadays it is very important to learn about many things practical oriented in nursing profession. So in every recruitment process like DSSB, AIIMS, BHU, then RRB, many recruitment ESIC, many recruitment, they are mainly focused on practical oriented scenarios. So at present there is a trend in nursing recruitment that is image based questions. So I thought that I can start the small YouTube channel. So this is my first video. So please comment, subscribe my channel. Today I am going to start some surgical instruments which is commonly used in hospital areas. So this is a surgical instrument for the staff nurse exams and skill test also. So first one is that Chittell's forceps. You know that many of many of the nurses are used this daily based. So uses of this Chittell forceps to remove the sterile instrument from boilers and formalin cabinets. They also used to ensure that each item removed, others are not infected. Means these are the forceps mainly used to transfer the sterile instrument from one place to the another place without any contamination, right? So here the care of the instrument is that we have to sterile this forceps and container for every operation session. So next one is the tooth tissue forceps. Tooth tissue forceps, it is used for grasping and holding tissue, muscles, skin surrounding wound. So especially this tooth forceps, it will come in a different sizes, like 1 into 2 or 2 into 3 or 3 into 4. Means that one head is having a 1 or 2 or 3 tooths, another one have the 2 or 3 or 4 tooths. Okay, so they are mainly used for holding of the tissues or grasping of the tissues. Sometimes hard tissues, fibrous tissues, you need to hold that during the any surgical procedures. Okay, like any fibrous tissues you need to hold. So by that, so next one is a plain thumb forceps. This is a plain one, it is not having any tooths here to hold the hard tissues. It is mainly used to hold the soft tissues, like used to tissue to place when applying the sutures. So when you are applying for the soft tissues, sutures, it is used and used to gently move tissues out of the way during exploratory surgeries. Means to remove any organs when you are doing the surgeries. So to move the organs from one side to another side, we are using this thumb forceps. Used to insert packing into or remove object from the deep cavities. So if there is any objectives are there, like any foreign bodies in a nose or any ear, so we are going to use this. Even sometimes insect stings, so ear packs are there, so to remove. Even sometimes the tubings also there to inserted in our body, so that to remove the tubes also, this thumb forceps are commonly used in a clinical areas, right? So next one is a Brown Edson tissue forceps. So this is mainly used for it is like a fine and rat tooth tips provide the gentle grasp of the tissue. These forceps are frequently used in surgery to manipulate soft tissue such as the fascia and skin during the suturing. So this is another type of the suture forceps, that is a Brown Edson forceps. So it is having the some tooths like a rat tooth, like tips will be there, so that will be helps to hold the tissues. Next one is a curved mosquito hemostat. So this is another type of the mosquito forceps. So it is mainly used to hold the delicate tissue, means very soft, like blood vessels, mucous membrane. So this kind of soft membranes to hold, so they are going to use this curved mosquito hemostatic forceps, and used to compress the blood vessels when there is a any bleeding, severe bleeding is there, any cut in the blood vessels. So they are going to clamp that blood vessels here with this mosquito hemostat. Even surgeries also, when during the surgeries there is many major arteries are cut, so they are going to clamp with this mosquito hemostat forceps. So next one is a Kocher hemostat forceps. So it is another type of the forceps where it is used to hold the securely superior thyroid pedicle tissues. Pedicle vessels or pedicle tissues means the vessels which is attached to the any prominent bony prominent areas, any organs, other organs. So here when blood vessels are attached to the thyroid, so during the thyroid surgeries they are going to separate these blood vessels from the thyroid gland. They are using this forceps, Kocher's hemostatic forceps. And also it is helped in hold the ribs during the resection to cause the artificial rupture of the gestational membrane. So membrane ruptures also they can be done through this Kocher's hemostatic forceps. So that is a obstetrical use. So next one is the Kelly's forceps. So this is another type of the Kelly's. You can see in this diagram how it is the tip of the this Kelly's forceps. To clamp off blood vessels, remove small root tips and grasp loose objects, it can be used. And a straight cut scissors like forceps with a grooved or shattered blades intended for use in a constricted blood vessels. When there is a constricted blood vessels are there, so to hold that, this Kelly forceps can be used to prevent the bleeding. Next one is the Hall-stated mosquito forceps. All-stated mosquito forceps is another type of the forceps which is used typically hemostatic agent to compress the smaller vessels. This is mainly used for to compress the small blood vessels and regulates the blood flow. These forceps contain ratchets ring handle to ensure the tight clamps, because here you can see here they have the lock, so that will be helps to maintain the tightness. So that ratchets are helps to maintain the tightness, how much you can want to keep the tight, that much you can able to keep the type of that forceps, right? So next one is a Kriel forceps. Kriel forceps is the another type of the forceps where we can use for primarily used for the clamping of blood vessels and tissues. So most of the forceps are used to clamp or to hold tissues. Okay, so this is another type of the forceps that is named as a Kriel forceps. You can see here how the body is there. So it is around 5.5 centimeters inches. Okay, next one is the Satin Sky forceps. This is another one forceps which is mainly used for the cardiac surgeries. This is the highly versatile cardiac clamp that can be used for the wide variety of these scenarios that requires clamping of the vessels for the partial or total occlusion of the vessel. So this is mainly used to occlusion. Occlusion means to block the blood vessel, to block the blood vessels or to block the any flow of the blood through the blood vessels. Okay, so this instrument is designed specially for the use in clamping the vena cava. It may be superior vena cava, it may be inferior vena cava. Especially this forceps used during the any kind of the cardiac surgeries. Okay. Next we can see LS forceps. This is common forceps. You can see here the you can see the end of the LS tissue forceps. Teeth are there. So these teeth are helps to hold the skin while raising skin flaps. So whenever you are doing the any flapping of the skin, so you can use this LS forceps. Used to pick up fold of the peritoneum during the laparotomy. So laparotomy also we can use during laparotomy to hold the abdomen walls. We can use this. Next one is to hold the linea alba while closing the midline incisions. So these are the uses for the LS forceps. So another one is a Babcock's. This is having the this is a specialty of this tissue forceps is that this is a not sharp one, this is a blunt one. So the tips of this Babcock's are having a blunted tip. So this blunted tips are helps to pick up the appendix during the appendectomy. Means if you are using any sharp one, so there may be damage to appendix and can be ruptured, and explosion will be takes place. So this Babkov can be used because this is having the blended tip used to hold delicate visceral organs, because if you are using any sharp one, that delicate visceral layers can be damaged and a rupture will be takes place. So this is a hard ending tip, so you can use this Babkov for a soft tissues. It is also used to margins of the bladder during the. So this is another type of the forceps that is called as the alligator forceps. This is mainly used to remove the foreign bodies or any objects from cavities. So alligator forceps are surgical instrument used for grasping small objects or removing items from the small cavities in the body. So especially it is used in ENT clinicals. Okay, so this is having a 45 degree angle to grip and a small set of the shattered jaw at the tip. So in this tip you can see there is a 45 degree of angle of grip is there, so that will be hold the any object. For example, if there is any foreign bodies in ear or in a nose, so this forceps can be inserted and it can be hold the foreign bodies and can be removed. So next one is a Lister sinus forceps. So this is another type of the forceps which is used to do the IND, insertion and drainage of the abscess. So while cleaning this abscess, this kind of the Lister's forceps can be used to clean the wound by holding of the swab through this forceps, and also can drain out this any kind of the abscesses through tubes by holding this forceps. So another special instrument that is a Doyen's intestinal clamp. So this is another kind of the forceps which is mainly used for the gastrointestinal tract surgeries. So it is used for the resection, anastomosis of the intestine in case of the stagnated hernia, accidental injury to the guts, intestinal growth, gastric intestinal bypass operations. So this is specially made for the gastrointestinal surgeries. That name is that Doyen's intestinal clamp, non-crushing. So another one is the Valsalam. So this is another one. So mostly used in obstetric and gynecology procedures. So Valsalam forceps are most often used in the obstetrics and gynecology procedures. Each pair of the surgical forceps hook at the tip of the each blade and are used to grab the uterus and cervix during the procedure. So these are the Valsalam forceps mainly used to hold the cervix when there is a dilatation to make the dilatation or to do the any surgical procedure on cervix or uterus. So they are using this Valsalam forceps. So next one is a sponge holder. This also commonly you might have seen to hold the sponge gauze pieces, square gauze pieces, and mop up the surgical site. You know that if any there is any procedures is there, so to paint the body with a antiseptic solutions, or sometimes to wipe the body if there is any bleeding is there, to wipe the with the gauze paste. So you can use this sponge forceps to hold the gauze pieces, because the end, the tip of this forceps having the zigzag jaw. Okay, so there are some rough surfaces which is a help to hold the gauze pieces. So next one is a needle holder. So this is another instrument where we can use to hold the needles, used to hold and pass the suturing needles through the tissue as a groove to hold the needles within jaws. So here in this tip you can see, so there are the some grooves where they can hold the needles. So next one is a Mayo-Hager needle holder. This is another type of the needle holder. This instrument is used to hold and manipulate curved needles. So this is especially used for the curved needles during the surgical procedure. This is the heavy needle drive with mildly tapered tip and no cutting blades. So this is another one, that is a towel clamp. So you know that during the procedure we are using the mini towels to cover the body. So add weight to drafts and towels to ensure they stay in place, allow the exposure of the operative site. So this is mainly purpose of the this travel plan. Okay, so this completes the today's topics. Please like, subscribe, and thank you for watching my video. So I hope